What's up guys and welcome back to another video. Today's video we're talking the Currie Cup semi-finals that are kicking off on Saturday. First one, obviously the Bulls taking on the Lions, which this video is about. And then the second one, which is Western Province taking on the Sharks. So stay tuned, hit the subscribe button, that preview will follow this one. So much to look forward to this weekend as the four South African top teams battle it out to see who are the Currie Cup champions. Currie Cup, so much history, one of the oldest tournaments in the world of rugby and from a provincial level. And I'm excited to see how it all goes down. Obviously, there's been a lot of talk in the media of South African rugby not being up to standards, but it's been a tough time. We've been playing, obviously, under COVID restrictions, no crowds, which is a tough one for everyone playing rugby around the world. Not only that, it is the middle of summer where we get bloody hot degrees out there, and it's tough for the guys to play when they're so used to playing in winter and all of that jazz. But we've got two phenomenal semi-finals to look forward to this weekend, and only fitting we're seeing these guys head north next in a few months time, hopefully all things going to according to a plan for the Pro 16 / Rainbow Cup, which will be an exciting tournament of itself. The four teams that have made the semi-finals are indeed the four teams that are going up for the tournament. Let's kick off with the Bulls taking on the Lions. A lot to look forward to. The Bulls have named a hell of a mean squad with quality players within the side, captained by Dwayne Vermeulen. If we look at the Lions, another strong team that they've named, which has been brilliant to know because we want to see a quality game. Elton Yankees is leading the Lions this weekend in a game which should be a phenomenal Transvaal derby, which should be brilliant. The only thing I'm hoping is we see more tries than kicks this weekend. It's going to be a battle between the tens. Monet Steyn's been in the news recently, having said that he's not throwing away an opportunity to be back in the green and gold for the Springboks. He's been in good form with the Bulls and will want to continue that going into this weekend. And on the other end is obviously Elton Yankees, who will be wanting to do the exact same thing, putting his name down as a possible candidate for fly-off position. Not long until the Lions Cup, and that's going to be the interesting thought, is who's going to get selected. Both teams have named solid squads, as mentioned. I think what I'm curious to see is the front row pack for the Bulls. You've got Lizo, you've got Trevor Nyakanya, experienced guys who've got the green and gold on it, with Skalky Rasmus, who's been pretty much an incredibly talented bloke for the Bulls at number two. He's going to be feeling comfortable having the protection of those guys alongside him. Cornell Hendricks, number 12, phenomenal story he's got. Looking forward to seeing what he's got to do. Ivan Fazel, scrum up position, so important to keep control and take a stance at the game and lead from the front. Marco van Staden at number six for the Bulls, another player to look out for. But having said that, the Lions have also named a phenomenal squad. You've got Willem Alberts, who's got experience in these types of vestrates in these types of matches, and he's going to be a force. Another guy's experience is Yanni Duplessis, who will be also wanting to show that yes, he may be of age, but he's still got the quality to keep up with the level of fitness that the other players have. Other guys, Tian Swanepoel, I think, has had a solid tournament and will be looking to really continue the form and keep their back line strong, along with Steen Pienaar and Skorsan on the wings, because they are going to want to get those tries, get every opportunity and going forward. And like I mentioned, with the Bulls, Van Sales, important role as number nine. Andre Varner as well needs to really shine, show up, show the skill level that he can indeed produce in the Currie Cup performance. And I think it's going to be a hell of a contest. Some other guys to look out for is Marvin Ari, a brilliant player. Yaku Creel, Vincent in number seven. On the center positions, you got Burger Ordendahl, another great talent, Wandisile as well. Bulls also phenomenal guys, looking out. Who's how the battle needs to go is you need to obviously play strong rugby, quality rugby. It is final, so anything can happen. You go with Jake White, he's going to be confident, he's ready, he's taking this thing serious. It says in the headline, the Bulls mean business. They're already Super Rugby Unlocked champions. They would love the Currie Cup title to their name as they prep for the Rainbow Cup and a few other things that are scheduled for this year. They want to put their names on the map. They want to continue the great form that they've produced. Last time these two teams met, it was an exciting encounter. That second half was definitely intense, but then the Bulls just seem to come away with it. And if the Lions want any form of picking up a victory this weekend, they need to be top-notch. They need to be able to play a full 80-minute games. If you tire or get weak, then you are sitting in problems, because the Bulls have the capacity to keep going on. So it's going to be a hell of a phenomenal contest with these guys, but it all comes down to the bench. You've got Ross Cronier for the Lions, who's experienced, who knows situations like this. You've got Ruan Dreher, you've got Willem van der Sluis, you've got Morne van der Berg, Dan Creel for the Bulls, just mentioning a few. For the Lions, now the Bulls, Imbros Papier hasn't had a bad season at all, really shone for the Bulls in my opinion, plays a better game for the Bulls than a fight for the Springboks. Arno Boert at number 12, Jan Ace at number 19, Clarks van Ruin, Johan Grobler, this quality, and it's going to be important for that bench to really stick it out. As mentioned in the start of the video, it's going to be hot, it's going to be summer conditions. These guys are going to need to stand strong, stand tall, and be ready for this occasion. As for prediction wise, look, these games are never easy, and they're not easy to predict, definitely. But I think for the sake of all things going, I think the Bulls are definitely going to take this one. I hope it's a close contest, and who knows, maybe we'll get surprised and the Lions will pick it up. But I just think from an experience point of view, the Bulls have a few more players in the cap. I mean, you've got Springboks in there, you've got the leadership of Dwayne Vermeulen. Not saying the leadership of Alton Yankees isn't as great, but there just seems to be more security within that Bulls squad, and I just feel they're going to take this one on it. But it should be a hell of a contest. Be sure to let me know your thoughts in the comment section down below. First semi-final, Bulls taking on the Lions. I'm going Bulls to win. I'm not going to give prediction for the sake of Super Brew, but I think the Bulls will win this one. That's going to do for today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, smash the thumbs up button, subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you guys real soon for another one. Stay safe and never give up. Cheers.